At just 26 years old, Singaporean American fireball Christian Lee has already solidified his legacy as one of the greatest fighters in ONE Championship history. A three-time champion and armed with an explosive ability to end a fight in an instant, Lee is a true knockout artist and a force to be reckoned with inside the cage. He's a grappling maestro with fists of fire and fury, capable of rattling anybody's precious brain cells. So before he makes his much-awaited return to the ONE Circle, let's recap his legendary career. Born in Vancouver to a Chinese-Singaporean father and a South Korean-born Canadian mother, Christian Lee moved to Hawaii when he was just 5 years old. With both parents being accomplished martial artists, it was no surprise that Lee started training in the sport from a young age, and his talent shone early on. At the 2012 USA Pancration National Championships, Lee clinched two national titles and a silver medal, whereas he went on to win the world championship in the MMA division at the 2012 World Pancration at Lima Federation Championships. The warrior kept racking up medals in 2013 before shifting his focus to mixed martial arts and making his debut in 2015 against David Meek. The warrior came out guns blazing, rushing for a finish with a few missed punches, before cracking Meek with a foot to the face and finishing the job with his fist of fury.
Christian Lee just absolutely pounced on that.
It was a proud moment for Lee and his elder sister, Angela, who went on to improve to 4-0 on the same card. Being a younger sibling to a rising star is never easy, but Christian proved that he was just as good as Angela when he stepped inside the ONE Circle for the second time in January 2016, where he faced Mahmoud Diab Muhammad, who tasted Christian's thunderous might early. Christian, a master of the mat, swiftly pounced on his semi-conscious opponent and deftly applied a Peruvian necktie. Muhammad scrambled back to his feet somehow, but was on rubber legs again. Moments later, Lee locked in a Kimura and put his senior out of his misery. A couple of months later, Lee returned to the ONE Circle, facing another stern test in the form of Anthony Engelin, who tasted the then 17-year-old kid's power early. Though he had badly rattled Engelin, Lee was in no hurry as he continued to crack his foe at will. Owing to Lee's masterclass on the feet, Engelin went for a desperate takedown, but even that backfired. Engelin scrambled back up, only to go down harder. From top position, Lee rained down fury on his opponent. With Lee ever so dominant and Engelin too tough for his own good, the referee decided to take matters into his hand and stop the massacre. The warrior continued to rise up the rankings by conquering whoever ONE put in front of him, including Kerry Bullos, who was dispatched in a half a round thanks to a Darce choke. With 5 first-round finishes, the 17-year-old prodigy felt he was ready to rock and roll with the best guys in the division. But Aussie Martin Wynn gave him a cruel reality check by handing him a submission loss. It was Lee's first career nap, and he woke up a different fighter when he faced ONE John Ping. Given his loss, Lee kicked things off with caution, and that allowed the Chinese fighter to tee off with some big shots. Once Lee found an opening, he pounced on John Ping like a tiger jumping out of the bushes. On the mat, Lee decimated John Ping and stopped him with a TKO to bounce back in style.
He saw it coming, took his chance.
Lee's next fight was way tougher, with another rising star in the form of Keanu Suba giving him a run for his money. Lee wasted no time and charged straight at Suba, who was game as well. The first round saw Suba gain the upper hand, outstriking Lee throughout with a mix of attack and defense. Things went up a notch in the second round as Lee emerged from his corner like a hungry tiger, rocking Suba to have his alarm bell ringing. But Suba responded with a takedown and stinging ground and pound. Lee returned the favor a couple of minutes later. In the third round, Lee knew his path to victory lay in taking Suba down again, and sensing his opponent's fatigue, he swiftly took Suba down and transitioned into a triangle choke. Lee then transitioned seamlessly into an armbar that forced Tsuba to tap out. The Warrior improved his streak to 3 wins in a row against Kutetsu Boka, dancing between stances like a cunning predator early and sizing up its prey before bringing Boku to the canvas. Boku showed great technique and grit in getting back up, but unfortunately, he was completely outgunned against a supreme grappler, who, after a few scrambles, secured a tight body lock and hurled the seasoned veteran to the mat with a thunderous suplex, knocking him out cold. Another impressive win later, Lee secured a featherweight 155-pound title shot against the only man to beat him, Martin Nguyen. But Lightning unfortunately struck twice, with Nguyen winning by a closely contested split decision this time. Lee faced a second straight setback against Edward Kelly in September 2018, losing by a disqualification after pulling off an illegal suplex in a fight he was convincingly winning. With two losses on the trot, Lee knew that the margins of error at the top of the pile were few and far between, and so he promised to work harder than ever. Christian's road to redemption started with Kazuki Togedami, just a month after his disqualification loss. The two grapplers tried their best to stamp their authority on the fight, but neither could make a strong mark. So, Lee decided to use his trump card, his piston of a right hand that dropped Togedome like a house of cards. With Kazuki badly hurt, Lee rained down heavy ground and pound. A couple of months later, Lee rematched Edward Kelly in the hope of seeking redemption, and he and his fans weren't disappointed. The Wushu fighter teed off with a few strikes early, but as soon as Lee grabbed a hold of him, he dragged him into deep waters. Lee initially went for submissions, but then decided to unleash violence in the form of ground and pound, chewing his foe and spitting him out in style. With two wins on the bounce and given his performances in the ONE Championship over the years, Christian Lee got his second shot at gold against Japanese legend Shinya Aoki for the 170-pound lightweight belt. The Japanese BJJ wizard had his young counterpart in a world of trouble in round one. And at one point, he almost touched the finishing line with an armbar, but Lee had zero quit on him. Lee miraculously survived the first round, and in round two, he turned the tables on the vet in the biggest of ways possible, knocking him out cold with a crushing right hand. With that, the Lee family now had two gold belts, as Angela Lee was already ruling the women's atomweight division with an iron fist. It was a monumental moment, but the best was yet to come. For Lee's first title defense, ONE Championship had arranged a World Lightweight Grand Prix tournament, with the winner getting a shot at gold. The tournament final initially featured Sagedagi Arslanilov and former UFC Bellator champion Eddie Alvarez, who had to withdraw due to injury. Guess who stepped in on short notice to take on a scary one-punch Dagestani monster on a four-fight winning streak? The champ himself. The fight was a wild ride, with Doggy unleashing heat on Lee early, though Lee finished the round on top. However, Lee mounted a comeback in round two, using his wrestling to dominate a tired Doggy.
Christian ties him up again.
In round three, Lee continued to dominate on the mat with submission attempts and takedowns. After three rounds of war, Lee silenced more naysayers and added another feather in his cap, the World Grand Prix title.
Christian Lee!
With a seriously tough contender essentially in the rearview mirror, Lee looked ahead and fought Lurie Lapikus. Lee started the fight like he had a bus to catch, and he almost got run over. For the next couple of minutes, Lapikus dominated Lee. But then, the tables turned. As soon as Lee got the fight to the mat, he secured full mount and finished the job with vicious ground and pound to add another rising contender to his list of vanquished foes. Lee's next title defense came against Russian slugger Timofey Nastyukin, who, like the many that came before him, was expected to give Christian a run for his money, and though he did, it was short-lived. Lee carefully backpedaled, as Nastyukin came forward with the same amount of caution. After a minute of stalemate, the Russian launched a ballistic missile, but was countered with a nuke that landed on the button. A few seconds later, the fight was over. Lee's next title defense was the toughest fight of his career, courtesy of South Korea's Oh Kra-yoon, who was coming off a sensational upset win against Eddie Alvarez. Both fighters started cautiously, but Lee soon closed the distance and took Oak to the canvas. Oak managed to get back up, but was taken down again. Late in round two, Lee took Oak's back and attempted a standing rear naked choke, but the resilient South Korean's defenses were rock solid. In round three, Oak dropped Lee to a knee early, but Lee returned the favor in a big way. Oak looked fresher entering round four and landed effective right hands as Lee kept coming, but it was a much closer fight than the earlier rounds. Lee was slowing down with each passing minute, but with less than a minute left, he badly rocked Oak. Lee hoped that his final fury would sway the judges, but Oak was announced the unanimous decision winner. The champ was visibly shocked.
I want an instant rematch. That was bullshit. Okay? I won that fight.
And so was ONE FC promotional bigwig, Chetri Sidyantong.
But I personally thought the judges got it wrong. I thought Christian Lee won unanimously.
Needless to say, the controversial ending to the fight led to an immediate rematch between the two. And Lee was itching to prove exactly why he was head and shoulders above his opponent.
I still feel like I'm the best lightweight fighter in the world.
Lee was off to a quick start, going guns a-blazing in the opening round and sending OK to the canvas twice. In round two, Lee landed a hard right hand that dropped his opponent again and blasted him with brutal knees to end his misery and reclaim the ONE lightweight championship. After reclaiming the 170-pound lightweight belt and taking home a performance of the night bonus, Lee demanded a shot at 185-pound welterweight champion Kamarian Abasov. The Warrior's wish was ONE championship's command, but he was almost made to regret it. When the two battled in November 2022, the Singaporean-American fighter was put on the back foot early and then dropped with an absolute nuke of a right hand. Lee showed a ton of heart in surviving a beatdown that lasted nearly a minute, and he miraculously managed to finish the round on the mat in a dominant top position. The two warriors went back and forth in the next two rounds. Lee turned up the heat in the fourth. The 25-year-old landed powerful punches and low kicks to slow down Abasov, eventually taking the fight to the ground.
Lee now for the double, shoots in and takes him down.
From there, Lee dominated with devastating ground strikes, leaving the Kyrgyzstani fighter with no answers. With a belt gracing both of his shoulders, Lee promised to rule lightweight and welterweight with an iron fist. But his plans of domination were temporarily halted by a personal tragedy.
You know, a true champion never quits, and so I found a way to come back.
A month after Lee's monumental win against Kayam Ryan Abasov, Lee's younger sister, Victoria, who was just making her entry into the ONE atomweight fold, died by suicide, leaving the entire family and the MMA world in a state of utter shock. In 2023, everything changed for the family as they closed their gym in Hawaii, months before Angela Lee announced her retirement and opened up about her sister's tragic death. Though Angela has no plans to compete ever again, Christian does, although he needs more time to heal from the tragic loss. In the meantime, the youngest of the four siblings, Adrian Lee, is hoping to inspire the family to resume their dominance in the Asian MMA scene. He made his MMA debut in June 2024, submitting Antonio Mamarella in the second round. As far as Christian is concerned, he will likely unify his lightweight title against the winner of the interim title fight between Oh Kra-yoon and Alisberg Razalov. Will Christian Lee make a comeback for the ages and fulfill his dream of becoming the greatest of all time? Is he one of the most electrifying knockout artists of our era? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. If you liked the video, please subscribe to our channel and turn on those notifications. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.